If you like seeing grass stand up like this and you want to get similar results, keep watching.
Hey y'all, and welcome to part 2 on how to build a static grass applicator. My name is Luke, and in this guide I'll be picking up the build from part 1. And we'll show you how to wire up the electronics of the static grass applicator. If you missed part 1, I'll put a link in the video description below. So, let's get started. First, I strip the end of the wires and tin them all. This makes it easier to solder to the various parts later. The high voltage output wire, which is the lonely red wire on the negative ion generator, needs to poke through this hole in the bottom of the applicator. To make this job easy, cut a length of black wire about half a meter, 1/8 inches, long. This will be used to feed through the small hole. Then solder it to the red wire and pull it back trough the hole, which will then pull the red wire trough, making the job very easy. Cut the black wire off and keep it aside, as this will be used for the negative connection that runs from the applicator to the layout. Next, I solder a plug onto the red wire and use shrink tube to help seal the rear of the plug. This stops small grass fibers from getting in behind the plug, and the plug will then connect to the lid once it's done. Later, I connect the black wire from the ion generator to the long black wire we just cut. Be sure to place shrink tube over the top before soldering to the switch. I tin the legs of the switch and connect the two black wires to the bottom corner of the switch. Then slide the shrink tube over the top and apply heat so it grips. On the opposite corner, attach the red wire. The switch should now look like this. The next piece is a red wire. I have already connected a plug to one end, and this will connect to the positive side of the power source. Then, in line with the other red wire already on the switch, connect this one to the center leg. Do the same again with the black wire. This is obviously the negative wire from the power source, and don't forget shrink tube. You want shrink tube because the handle will be shaken while in use, and you wanna avoid the wires touching. This is what the completed switch should look like. The long black wire needs to feed trough the small hole on the side. The two main power wires just poke out the top, so you should have your power in wires from the top, the negative ground wire out the side, and the high voltage output wire coming out the bottom. To secure the piece of wood inside the handle, I drill a hole in the back and insert a self-tapping screw that holds the piece of wood in place against the inside of the handle. And I do the same for the switch. The small screws hold the switch firmly against the handle. I attach an alligator clip to the negative grounding wire using pliers and solder to get a good electrical connection. For the last piece of wire, I fray one end. This will poke through the metal mesh on the lid. And on the other end, I solder a plug to connect to the power voltage output line. Remember to use shrink tube. And I poke the end through, twist the frayed wires together, and finally solder it onto the mesh. It's got a good hold on the mesh, as you can see. Finally, I trim off the excess, connect the two plugs and clip the lid on to the container. And that's the finished static grass applicator, ready for use. I connect it to a 12 volts phone charger. Make sure the wires don't touch. Put some static grass in the container Apply glue to the area you plan on grassing. Push a pin into the glue. Attach the alligator clip to the pin. Turn it on, and shake. As you can see from the photos, it does a great job and provides some very realistic scenes. It works great with all static grasses. The one I used in the demo is Woodland Snook Static Grass. And in the photos I used Mini Nature Static Grass. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this two-part guide and had fun building your own static grass applicator. As always, play it safe when dealing with electricity. And until next time, happy railroading. Cheers!